Please, thanks. Walk through the doors and through the halls of illusions. Visit yours and see what could have, it should have, it would have been real. But you had to f up the whole deal.
Let's take a walk down the hallway. It's a long way, it takes all day.
And when we get to the end, you'll find a chair with straps and chains. We slap you in there, lock you down tight so you can't move a thread, and pull your eyelids up over your head. Cause you're about to witness an illusionary dream.
This next match is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute television time limit.
Is that, that's where
first, accompanied by his manager, Angelo Stefano. He hails from Heartbreak, USA, at 215 pounds, Tasty Travis Lee.
We got action for you all night long and all the way live right here on All-Star Championship
live.
Wrestling.
Hey, is Tasty Travis Lee wearing any pants?
I don't know. It's firing, it's coughing, and once again, the superstar, one half the tag team champions, Mike Mercer. That's just disturbing.
Wow.
I can't think of anything more disturbing than that.
Unless there's Stefano not wearing pants. Oh, no, that's a visual we don't need.
Don't even go there.
Oh.
I guess Tasty Travis wanted to show off those quadriceps there. Got some new gloves,
you know,
too.
I noticed Stefano keeps smacking him on the ass a little too much.
At 205 pounds from Loves Park,
oh,
New Jersey.
Oh, he's going to get smacked all right.
The Hardcore Luchador, Dino Bambino.
This is a man who can smack him around, smack anyone he wants around. He is all the way hardcore, and he is fearless.
He's
Dino.
Also an idiot. He's the Hardcore Luchador, Dino Bambino. Here's a man that takes risks that he doesn't have to take just to please the stupid, moronic fans.
There's one of them right there, Dino Ban Stupid. No, I don't know if that's his name or not. But the ACW, the watering hole, all across the United States, people are falling in love with the high-flying athletic style, the fearless style of this kid, Dino Bambino. And he is a kid, he's only 23 years old.
And for the record, I did not cut off my blonde lock to look more like Dino Bambino.
Well, he, of course, was shorn by MPW.
Mulletized. We're going at it already. Tasty Travis Lee tried to get the advantage. Cut off by Bambino, up and over at the leapfrog. Whoa, went for from the backside. You'd think Tasty Travis would like it from the backside, but, well, he got a smack on the ass to Dino Bambino.
There seems to be a little too much of that going on right now.
Unfortunately so.
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
No. Let's qualify ourselves. But yeah, every time I look at it, it's more and more disturbing, those short, hot pink
They don't
tights.
Call him Tasty for nothing.
I don't need that.
Did Dino need his hand to be there? Oh, reverse atomic drop. He's going to have to sanitize that thing. Atomic drop!
Every intelligent wrestler picks a body part. I guess Bino just picked that one.
He's smarter than you think. drives him into that corner.
Now what is he going
to
do?
I shudder to think.
Oh!
Pounding on the gluteus maximus, the dorsal muscles being punished on Tasty Travis Lee.
I think he just broke his Abdullah Amamgada.
And that's not an everyday occurrence for Travis, but it's close.
Wow.
Dino Bambino, Tasty Travis Lee, already sort of getting into... Whoa! Stefano with a timely assist there, and he hung Bambino out to dry. Went for that high-risk offense. Poor Travis.
Still feeling the effects. Ow. That... You know,
that
you
blatant choke in there as he tries to collect them or
you
collect
you never saw the Baron von Raschke put the claw on there, did you?
I think the Baron had too much sense. Well, we can see what we want, but it was effective as Angelo Stefano, a man who knows Dino Bambino very well, gets the trip in there. Travis a little bit off until they count a one, though, from Jamie Kennedy. Superstar. You know Dino Bambino very, very well, my friend.
This is a man. We've had matches in Missouri. We've had matches in Minnesota. We've had matches in Iowa, Wisconsin, Illinois, Indiana. We've brought our feud all over the Midwest. And I know for a fact that Tasty Travis Lee is going to have to be in tip-top condition at the top of his toes to beat a superstar like Dino Bambino.
Tasty Travis Lee accustoming himself to singles competition now in ACW. Bambino's firing back, though. Couple rights to mid. There it is again!
Fool
Finally
me
was
once.
Caught. Oh!
Shame on you. Fool me twice. Shame on me. Dino Bambino's an idiot.
And shame on the guardrail for making a hell of an indentation on the jawline of Dino Bambino. Look at that. Stefano getting his cheap shots in, and a perfect setup for Tasty Travis Lee. That flying drop kick right through those ropes.
I think those hot pink tights give Mr. Tasty what? Travis an advantage.
Stefano! I almost saw something I didn't want to see. Stefano was going to work on Dino Bambino. Let's just leave it at that. German suplex! He's got a hold of it, chained to Chris Benoit. Another one, well done.
He's folding Bambino in half.
So much compression on that neck, on that spinal column, only a count of two though.
Tasty Travis Lee doing very well tonight against Dino Bambino. And if he were to beat Bambino, it would be considered an upset. Tasty Travis now barking at the fans at ringside. Instead of taking care of business, Dino's getting to his feet.
Kaufman, if you're not busy on Monday, you might as well book Bambino's Cairo appointment right now.
That's not very tasty what happened to Travis. I'll tell you what, though, guys, despite this, he seems a little bit more focused as time for chops turns out in singles competition than he does in tag. Look out for Bambino. This is why they call him the Hardcore Luchador. That top rope offense, that high-impact aerial offense.
Oh!
What the hell was that?
Oh my
variation
God!
Variation of a Michinoku driver off the top rope.
Tasty Travis Lee.
Travis Lee may never stand again. But there's Stefano trying to buy. He may have to buy a lot of time.
That's a good way to end a career. Tasty Travis knows if there's one place you don't mess with the Hardcore Luchador, it's the top rope.
Tasty Travis on Dream Street there. He caught Stefano by mistake. Apparently looking for Bambino.
Uh-oh.
Look out for it. We've seen this before. We've seen Sam Hayes suffer this. Beetlebomb!
Oh!
This one is a goner.
That is what you call high impact.
Dino Bambino is back in form and looking to climb atop the wrestling world.
Tasty Travis Lee gave it what he could, but Dino Bambino just too much tonight for the tasty one.
Tasty one, Stefano got to regroup, and Dino Bambino back for more here in ACW.
This next match is scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute television time limit. Your referee representing Midwest Pro Wrestling, Matty Lardinois. Our first competitor is from Minneapolis, Minnesota. He weighs in at 207 pounds, Shifty.
MPW representation in the watering hole, not just coming to the ring in the form of the former TV champion Shifty, but inside the ring as Matty Lardinois, the ACW turncoat, representing the official here. He's a licensed official. As Shifty trying to impress me or you, Doug?
I think he was looking at you, Matt.
Well, that's repulsive.
Maybe he was looking at Cleo. She's walking right in front of us.
I'm looking at Cleo.
I know I am too. I mean, we may not like Shifty, but, you know, he's not blind, is he?
No, he's not. The dude pays attention. He better pay attention tonight.
205 pounds from Loves Park, New Jersey, the Hardcore Luchador, Dino Bambino.
He is a fearless aerial opportunist. No one has more gut. No one takes more chances than Dino Bambino. He lays it all on the line, and he's a popular mainstay, a damn popular mainstay of ACW, wrestling barefoot. Got that Jungle Boy vibe going.
And gotta keep in mind, it was the work of Shifty and his MPW crew that cut the hair of Dino Bambino. These guys have history.
But you know what, Doug? This is gonna be a hell of a match. These are two very evenly matched physical athletes. Roughly the same height, roughly the same weight, roughly the same build, roughly the same experience. Dino Bambino, a hell of a lot more prolific, hello, inside the, on the air, in the air. I'll get this right eventually. Shifty, a little bit more of a ground tactician, a little bit more of a rule breaker. But these are two guys that can give each other a lot of trouble. And we're going to see it right here on All-Star Championship Wrestling.
Well, Dino's got to go up against Shifty here. That's tough anytime because right there in the white T-shirt, Matty Lardinois, the MPW house referee.
Who's fallen into the gap time after time again. It still stuns me how this kid turned up. Wow, what was that?
A drop kick right to the inner right thigh, and that put Shifty down, and Shifty's put down on the ring floor.
Dino had his hands behind his head, but he did that. Look out for Dino. Slide drop kick. This is another guy. Like Rough Rider Rashawn, even more so. You never know what this kid will come out with. He has no fear. It's time for chops for Shifty on the outside of the ring as the ACW crowds on the watering hole shouts their approval.
Two big thudding karate chops across the chest of Shifty. Now what does Dino have up his sleeve?
Oh, he went for that big karate kick, that roundhouse kick, caught that bare foot on the ring pole.
The top of his foot takes all the blow.
But Dino, he's not done yet. Look at that. Rolling senton off the apron into the guardrail. He sandwiched Shifty.
And it looked like Shifty was trying to escape, and he was unable to get out of the way.
No such luck. The ACW crowd shouting their approval. He's going to do it one more time. Not that time. Oh, my God.
Right across the chest, and the ribs are maybe a couple of broken ribs right now.
Bambino splattered himself. We are used to seeing him take risks. We are used to seeing him get hurt. It never gets easier. You always wonder when Dino Bambino has gone too far. This might have been a time he's gone too far as he is just writhing in pain outside the ring. Shifty! Pescado into the Hurricane Rana! Well done by Shifty. Well, talking about Shifty's aerial offense. Looks like he was out to prove me wrong.
Dino's world is rocked over there.
Great matchup between these two guys. Great athletes. One from Minnesota, one from Wisconsin by way of New Jersey.
Dino sprawled out in the corner.
Shifty laying in those vicious boots. Matty Lardinois not doing much about it.
Very slow count from Lardinois.
He's savoring the moment.
And Shifty looking for some approval from the audience.
You know, Matty Lardinois already getting on my nerves only a few weeks in, Doug. I hope that Mickey Doyle is keeping a close eye on MPW's official that he stole from ACW. Turned him over a Death Valley driver, a combination with a leg drop. Don't know what to call that one. Misses the lion's halt, though.
Shifty gets Dino down. Leg drop across the back of the shoulders, across the neck. Rolls him over for the pin. Quick count
Very
from Matty Lardinois.
Matty Lardinois is in full screw job mode right here as he takes Shifty side, takes MPW side, get Dino Bambino, nice drop kick.
Man, that is a full force drop kick.
Right in the rib cage, maximum impact. And here goes Shifty. Might be setting up for that Shifty screwdriver, that neck breaker off the top, second turnbuckle. He's off the top now, Dino Bambino's prone. Likely setting up for something else here, but taking a lot of time.
Oh, that frog splash. Nobody's home. Dino can now grab the momentum.
Dino's up. Dino's looking good. He's setting him up here. Look out. Dino takes him up. We've seen this before. Doug Bambino bomb. Splash Mountain DDT combination.
One, two.
Come on, Matty. What is Matty Lardinois?
Hey.
He's turning the pile around. Oh, for the love of God.
Oh,
that was weak.
Stuff, and here comes Mickey Doyle. He's watching it.
Mickey Doyle knows about weak officiating, but Mickey Doyle is ACW all the way. He's got something to say to Matty, I would hope. Shifty gets the scoop up. Take that, Matty. Booyah!
And he puts Matty Lardinois down on the pile driver. Our war is on.
Our commissioner has taken the center stage. Bambino counts to three. ACW, Doug, we're finally striking back.
Dino Bambino absolutely stoned out here by Larry.
Oh.
He said he takes those low blows.
Takes it down low. Shifty. Loker's got a chair.
This is not, I don't know, is it good or is it not good?
I have no idea what goes through Loker's mind anymore. I know he and Bambino are friends. I know they grew up together in Oshkosh, big right hand. Loker set him up.
Loker's at it.
Oh, my God!
Oh, Loker, I can't believe it!
That was no accident.
That was no accident.
He annihilated Dino Bambino.
What the hell is going on with BDL?
I was going to say, is he joining MPW? He just disposes of shit. God, that chair almost took out our table. Good God. Loker is a one-man wrecking crew.
He absolutely devastates Dino Bambino, and man, I don't think it was any accident.
What the hell?
I said it when he came out, whose side is he on? I don't think we know yet.
Big Daddy Loker has gone psycho. Big Daddy Loker, oh God, look at Bambino. I never saw, we gotta see that chair shot again. So vicious.
Bambino crawls his way into the ring.
What the hell? I'm surprised he got his feet quick. He's got something to say.
Must not value life very much.
Dino doesn't know who hit him.
He doesn't know what happened to him. He just knows he got waylaid. As Loker is standing there, quite frankly, gloating over his work.
Which one of you MPW cowards was it? Show your face!
Now what?
It was me.
He just said it was Hain. Loker just said it was Hain that hit him with the chair. That's a flat out lie.
For 1 year, you and I were best friends. Whenever
I think he said it was me.
You had
my bad. I don't know what goes through his mind.
Last time we had a cage right here in the watering hole, it was you that saved my ass.
So what was that about then?
What is this? The last show, I was your referee. I didn't see the leg on the rope. I made the three count. I saw the tape. It was an honest mistake on my part, and I'm man enough to admit that. You're going to come in here and tell me you hit me with a chair? It was a mistake. I admit it. Does that mean come in and nail me with a chair? It was a mistake.
Some odd rationale here.
So is that.
Loker just said that was a mistake, just like Bambino counting the three on Hain over Loker for the number one contendership was a mistake.
I'm telling you, it did not look like a mistake to me, Matt.
No, it wasn't. That isn't getting more bizarre by the second. And ACW is a house divided right now.
And you don't need this. When the ACW-MPW showdown is coming up in a couple of weeks, you do not need to have the fighting on the inside.
No, indeed.
We're finally going to have a tag team title defense. Rock and Randy, Mike Mercury defending the belt against Sudden Impact coming up.
Coming out first, accompanied by his manager, Tommy Roxx, from Tampa, Florida, weighing in at 225 pounds, God's gift to women, Kevin Krueger.
ACW title defense right off the bat. Matt Byron and Doug Kaufman. Tommy Roxx wanders to the ring as we're waiting on the champ right now. Scott Stiflin, Kim Krueger. Well, Stefano's mom or whoever's mom that is.
Kevin Krueger has defended this ACW belt against everybody, and he gets Dino Bambino tonight.
What's going on? Where's God's gift to women? Where is the champ primping? He can't be. The mirror's out here.
Tommy Roxx is out here. John with the fans.
Wait a minute. Here's Kevin Krueger.
Dino!
They couldn't wait to start. Dino's in his street clothes. What the hell is going on here?
Dino got him backstage. Dino rocks him into the railing.
Dino Bambino, it's been too long since he's gotten an ACW title shot. He didn't want to wait at all in this one.
Dino in his boots, his do-rag.
Dino's in his street clothes. Dino didn't even want to dress to fight. He just wanted to fight.
Dino Bambino's got Kevin Krueger down. He's taking him up top.
Look out.
The Hardcore Luchador.
He is a fearless, dangerous individual. And Kevin Krueger's going to fight around.
Oh! There you go. One, two.
It's over.
New champion. New champion.
It's over.
New champion, Dino Bambino.
That was a match.
Dino Bambino has won the ACW championship.
Just like that.
Yeah.
Dino took his opportunity.
Dino.
What?
Dino Bambino. Tommy Roxx is unhappy. No.
Wait
a second. Roxx grabs it away.
Tommy Roxx is protesting.
Dino Bambino has won the title in Two Rivers.
We saw 1, 2, 3 right here in the community house.
Kenny, what's up?
Kevin Krueger is down. Dino's leading
the
belt.
I made a mistake. The bell didn't ring.
What?
The title didn't change hands.
What do you mean?
The bell didn't ring.
The bell didn't ring. Why the hell didn't you ring the bell then?
We got to restart this match. We got.
So now we get our match.
Now we're going to get a bell ring.
There you go, Jimmy Kennedy. Those Kennedy brothers once again putting those great minds to work as Kevin Krueger taking advantage of Dino Bambino. Now we've got a match. Wow.
Kevin Krueger spines him against the ring post. Dino's already beat him once. Now we got to go again.
Now we got a real match. We've got Krueger on the offensive after Dino exerted himself all over Kevin Krueger. Man, guys get to him. He's angry.
Dino ought to be angry.
They should both be angry.
Dino held the belt for like 5 seconds.
Jimmy Kennedy's parents should be angry for having him after that one. Look out for Bambino. Oh, he tried to set up. Oh, my God.
Backbreaker across it.
Dino Bambino, an unprotected, just flat out bunked on that guardrail. Had to be extremely painful as God's gift to women going right to work here.
Kevin Krueger lost the belt. But they
say
the
belt
didn't ring, so it didn't count.
He should have lost the belt. We saw a 3 count. We saw a shooting star press. But Jimmy Kennedy, I guess this one caught him by surprise. That's as much the benefit of the doubt I'll give him.
Never called for the bell to ring. The match never began. Unbelievable.
Right hands from Dino Bambino. Trying to fight his way back into this one. Catches him.
Oh,
went for that flying head scissors.
And he let a backbreaker on him. Remember, 60 seconds ago, Dino took the back against the rail.
And all of a sudden, Kevin Krueger has got a game plan. All of a sudden, the specimen, the multi-tool athlete of ACW, the champion, has got his game plan all worked out. The small of the back, the lower back of Dino Bambino being punished. Oh, God, give the women. Tommy Roxx distracting Jimmy Kennedy, which we now found out is very easy to do.
If Kamikaze Ken is the heart and soul of ACW, Dino Bambino is the guts of ACW. He takes more chances than anybody should right now. He was the ACW champion for a moment, but Jimmy Kennedy blew another one, and Kevin Krueger has him, and he's working over his back.
I'll tell you what, though, we've seen Dino Bambino come back from so much adversity in ACW. Of course, the feud with Sam Hain, the flaming table, the fireball to the face, the feud with Scrap Iron Adam Pearce. So much has come down on this kid, and he keeps fighting his way back up. He's got to fight his way back up from this Boston crowd from Kevin Krueger right now.
And Dino is in the middle of the ring. He has got to work his way out of it or somehow get to the ropes, and that lower back has been beat up here in the last 2 minutes against Kevin Krueger, and he's able to flip him over.
He looked on the verge of tapping, but that leg strength coming through for Dino Bambino right now. Tommy Roxx to the outside shouting instructions.
Unbelievable.
Man, the intensity has just been kicked up a notch here in Two Rivers, Doug.
If you like what you see on television, check out the website acwprowrestling.com and find out where we're going to be next.
And the intensity is just going to pick up because tonight our main event, one-on-one, the TV title on the line, Big Daddy Loker against Straight Edge Eric Hammers. We're going to find a very sudden and very violent grudge come to head. Oh, wow.
My God, look at that.
Maximum impact on the lower back, right into the turnbuckles. Kevin Krueger is just laying Dino Bambino to waste. And it's a shame, too.
Dino Bambino thought he'd won the title early.
We all did.
Jimmy Kennedy forgot to call for the bell to ring.
God's gift to women, perched on the top rope. We don't see him go up often, but he's usually effective when he does. Shotgun for our brother. He's a super fly splash. Nobody's home.
Dino's able to roll out.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Loker. Loker.
Oh,
who
no.
Doesn't he have an issue with?
And Loker comes out.
This is not the place for him to be.
Looks like he's applauding Dino on, but remember, Dino wore a chair for a hat a couple of weeks ago.
Needless to say, that sarcasm. Big Daddy Loker shouldn't be out here. Doesn't he have he has a match to prepare for, a TV title match to prepare for. Oh, this kid's just sour. Big right hand from Dino. Throwing those big right hands in. Kevin Krueger bagging off. Gets whipped in. Nice drop kick.
Great
what
drop
height.
Kick. Great drop kick. Dino, though, favoring his back a little bit.
Come on, bring him off. Oh, big chop. Dino's trying to set him up while he's still got the strength to do it. Wow, high elevation. That had to hurt his back, and it did.
Dino Bambino pointing to the top rope. Is he going to try it up top again? Yes, sir.
It worked for him one time. Now we've got a referee. Now we've got a bell ringer. But now we've got Tommy Roxx on the outside. Look out, Doug.
Tommy Roxx. Coming.
There he goes. Oh, my God.
And he's all tied up. He falls out. He got crotched across the top
rope. Right into Little Bambino. Tommy Roxx did his job perfectly there.
Kevin Krueger talking to Loker now.
Kevin doesn't have anything good to say to
no.
Loker.
And Krueger has issues with Loker.
Oh, here it comes again. Loker can't get along with anybody anymore.
Tommy Roxx has Jimmy Kennedy on one side. Loker.
Krueger spits
him. He slaps him across the face.
Here, it's going to break down, Doug. Gonna break down.
Dino, oh, Dino takes the right hand from Loker.
In the wrong place at the, or was he? Sets him up. Lady Killer coming.
And
he
Loker,
lays him out.
And Loker walks away.
Oh, and there goes Loker. Without a word.
It's another hosing of Dino Bambino.
And another intrusion by Big Daddy Loker, the most bitter man.
The winner is still ACW Heavyweight Champion, God's Gift to Women, Kevin Krueger.
Loker whacks it, lays him out with another right hand.
Kevin Krueger lucked out. That's all it is. Luck. He did not deserve it. I hate to say it, but he didn't deserve to lead that belt tonight. And thanks to Big Daddy Loker, and thanks to a big streak of luck, he got that gold deal of Dino Bambino going home empty on this one.
By Adrian Lynch, representing Midwest Pro Wrestling from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 207 pounds, Shifty.
Oh!
Jersey, Dino Bambino. The world is mine, nigga, get back. Don't fuck with my stack. The game's just whack. I'm about to drop the bomb, I'm the motherfucking champ. Big fish in a small pond.
Stores. You tell me who's not, who got the blue drop, who jewels not back, who got the blue drop, who jewels not back, who got the blue drop.
Let's get him.
Oh, you're blocked!
on, brother. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. 29. Let's go.
Shifty agreed to careers on the line here,
but it's all good. Two, Cody, so it seems.
One,
here comes another man.
Representing Championship Wrestling, the Hardcore Luchador, Dino Bambino.
What's going on here, guys?
Lynch is hiding on the other side of the ring because of Bambino. Inside and outside action going on. ACW and MPW going to war.
And Hammers has his face grated against the chain, against the cage inside.
As Adrian Lynch's mug meets the steel barricade, and now it's getting raked.
Look at that.
On the outside.
Oh, look at that.
That's why we call it Wisconsin cheese grater, Adrian. Welcome to it.
Wait, oh, Sheriff Johnny Emerald out of the chair.
What the hell is Sheriff doing on here?
He has nothing to do with this match.
Sheriff's got Mickey Doyle targeted. Or does he? I thought he was going for Mickey Doyle. He wants Bambino.
Johnny Emerald hiding behind a ringside photographer. He's got a chair in his hand.
Someone needs to take him out.
Oh, my God, look at Lynch. Look at Lynch.
Lynch is a mess. Lynch was lacerated along that steel cage.
Meanwhile, that's happening on the outside. Shifty continues to just tear apart Eric Hammers inside the ring.
Shifty got him set up right now.
Alexis is horrified by what she sees is Adrian Lynch's face.
Her shopping future might be in jeopardy. Look at this, though, on the inside of the ring. Look at Hammers. He picked up Shifty.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Are we just... He's got it set up.
Power slam. A power slam off the second rope, but Hammers takes it too, and he is bleeding above the right eye.
Hammers is a mess. Shifty looking to be a mess. Adrian Lynch is just busted wide open. Look at that!
Oh!
What agility by Dino Bambino!
Dino Bambino! Up kicks him right in the back of the head into the face.
Oh, but there, Emerald. Emerald getting payback from that chair shot in Two Rivers. With guts on behalf of Team ACW, but Sheriff John Emerald at MPW's done so many times, and hopefully not for the last time.
Well, the cage was supposed to keep everybody in. That lasted about 4 minutes.
Representing Midwest Pro Wrestling,
well, it's an MPW wrestler, Stallion. Or it's going to be Loker.
And it's going to be 5-on-2.
Because you've got to count Sheriff John Emerald out here.
And Abari's with them.
And Abari's with him.
Abari like a cockroach.
It is 6-on-2 now.
Way past ridiculous, Todd.
Look at that face of Adrian. It is raw hammered. He is bleeding profusely.
He's done damage. Adrian, there's no question about it. 6-on-2.
Where do you look? Look what they're doing to Eric Hammers in the ring.
They're going to launch him. From being used there, Doug. I learned that in physics class, but the physics not doing any benefits to Eric Hammers. And Doug, there's nothing we can do about it. 6-on-2, it's gonna be 7-on-2 in seconds.
Dino Bambino's ripped wide open as he takes big chops from Adrian Lynch at ringside. Eric Hammers is busted wide open. We've got five wrestlers, three of them are bleeding like pigs.
But ACW and the watering hole are firing up, the fans are firing up. It can't end like this, Doug. There's no way in hell it can end like this.
Eric Hammers being pounded by the Stallion who just came into the ring.
Stallion, a fresh man inside the ring, setting him up. Suplex, nicely done. Shifty poised on the outside. Big
leg drop. Massive leg drop by Shifty. This might be it.
How the hell does it end like this?
It is 3-on-2 with Johnny Emerald and Daivari on the outside. That's 5-on-2, throwing Alexis at 6-on-2, and Loker still has not yet come out.
Three men punishing Dino Bambino on the outside. He's still standing, though, despite the fact he's lacerated. Shifty and Stallion on the inside.
The fan over there puts a towel to Bambino's head to try to wipe the blood from his eyes.
And here it comes.
Here comes Loker.
One.
Good ACW.
Representing.
Dino's going up top.
All-star
Look at Dino. He's going up top. But he's going
big. Danny. Loker.
But look out. Dino's going to be power slam.
My God.
Oh, my God. He killed him.
He destroyed Dino Bambino with that Michinoku driver. And there's one. Goddamn chain. How the hell does it end like this? Loker coming as a damn weapon, and he can.
And Loker just walks in his MPW shirt. Dino Bambino is out in the middle of the ring. Stallion is choking out Hammers. Look at the face of Adrian Lynch. He's bleeding.
MPW has inflicted the ultimate indignity. He's chaining the damn cage shot.
This is unbelievable. Alexis.
Alexis.
Towel. She's going to lock up the ring. Alexis with Loker. They're chaining the ring door. Adrian Lynch screamed to lock the door. No one can get in. No one can get out.
They're going to draw this damn thing out, Doug. They're going to try and humiliate ACW.
It is 4-on-2, and Loker's the wild card. Loker has issues with Bambino and with Eric Hammers.
This is a pile of crap is what this is.
They have locked the door.
These freaking Minnesota mullets. Grandstand at our expense.
Adrian
Make
Lynch.
Their careers our expense. Look at that. Loker.
Shaking hands with Loker.
A bloody Adrian Lynch, but Loker's ready to go.
Hammers
is roadkill right now.
This is unbelievable. This is unbelievable. It's not supposed to end like this.
No, it's not. How the hell does ACW go down like this? 3 years. 3 years.
Look at Dino Bambino.
3 years we've made our name in Wisconsin, performing in front of some of the greatest fans. And it goes down to a bunch of traitors and Minnesota mullets.
Wait a second.
Wait. Dino, look. Do you see that jerk, Doug?
Loker's ACW.
The Midwest.
Loker's ACW.
Machine.
It's a gore.
The gore. The Midwest
ACW
machine.
And
Loker. You can't do a thing about it.
Unbelievable! And MPW can't get in!
They can't do anything but watch! It's fair, Doug! Three on the way it's supposed to be!
Of course, Bambino and Hammers are out on their feet! But it's 3-on-3! It's finally even!
You don't come in our house, in our territory, and think we're gonna go down without fighting your asses! ACW is gonna fight you!
Jimmy Kennedy, when you count a pin! Lynch, a bloody mess, screaming at the fans!
ACW is going to fight you tooth and nail.
Loker!
Look at that! The powerful Big Daddy Loker, double clothesline. Adrian Lynch tries to get in there, nothing doing.
Look at this. Oh, Lynch head first! Now he has Shifty! Head first again!
We are going to send them back to Minnesota, Doug. We are going to send these freaking mullets back to Minnesota. Look at Hammer.
Hammer's trying to get up top, but he has just been beaten to a pulp. MPW is down. Hammer's at the top of the ring. He's at the top of the cage.
This is ACW style.
Dino goes up.
This is what we're all about.
Dino's up.
This is what we are all about. Guts, determination, ability.
Everybody's on their feet.
Shooting
star. Oh, my God. I can't believe what I saw.
Eric Hammer is 15 feet in the air. 15 feet. You're gone.
This is a night these fans in the watering hole will never, ever forget as ACW, loud and proud, come away and they're taking care of MPW.
Big Daddy Loker. Big Daddy Loker. No doubt a swerve. No doubt we got inside those Minnesota Mods heads and we did it. Bambino, Hammer, Loker. What a night for All-Star Championship Wrestling. Kamikaze Ken Anderson, your new heavyweight champion. Doug, the proudest moment in our history, and I'm glad to be a part of your kickoff party. Nothing's it's guts. Tons and tons of guts inside the ring. And MPW is a heat.
And what happens now?
ACW in charge, MPW hit the road, Matt.
It's back the way it should be. It's back the way ACW is meant to be. Not gang attacks, not sackless attacks. It is nothing, it is athletes taking on athletes. And three of the finest athletes, three of the gutsiest athletes inside that ring right now representing ACW. I am damn proud to be a part of this.
And look at the face of Adrian. He is just a bloody mess at the hands of primarily Dino Bambino and the rest of ACW. And Big Daddy Loker came through when he needed to.
No longer will MPW or any of its representatives disgrace this ring, dog. Hammers, Bambino, and yes, Big Daddy Loker have made damn sure of that.
What a night, man. Kickoff Carnage 2001. The fans of the watering hole will never forget it. Where is ACW going to be next? Check it out. ACWProWrestling.com. Catch it live and in person.
We're still here. We're still standing. We're going to see you every Saturday night on UPN 32. Fans, ACW home videos, ACW right events. They're still going on. The Midwest ass kicking machine is alive and well. For Doug Kaufman, I'm Matt Byron. The proudest moment in ACW history. You see it here on Kickoff Carnage. We'll see you next time.
Polaroids inside the cage following tonight's event.
Job!
First, accompanied by superstar Mike Mercury from Vulcan, Michigan, weighing in at 250 pounds. The Predator, Jason Green.
Doug, here's another match. We had a shot called not too long ago. Dino Bambino wants to get his hands on superstar Mike Mercury, just like he has so many times in the past. But to do that, he's got to get through one of the most impressive rookies I've seen come through the Dojo of Pain and through All-Star Championship Wrestling in many, many months. The Predator, Jason Green, is just a chiseled athlete, and he is looking to make his name against one of the most skilled, one of the most astute high flyers in the United States of America. We're talking about Dino Bambino.
And his opponent, weighing in at 205 pounds, from Loves Park, New Jersey, the Hardcore Luchador, Dino Bambino.
Now, Dino Bambino is coming out, and I think it would be safe to say, Matt Byron, to use an insider term, I am a mark for Dino Bambino. I think this is the guy. I know you think Kamikaze Ken is the ACW champs, the heart and soul, but I think Dino Bambino is the guts of ACW. When there's been a fight, he's been right there. He has been part of the most memorable matches in the history of ACW, including just an incredible gut check match, ACW versus MPW at Kickoff Carnage when he bloodied Adrian Lynch.
Doug, this kid continues to write new chapters in his career. A few years ago, I saw a skinny kid break out from obscurity using sheer guts, you said it yourself, and the will and the ability to put his body on the line and do anything it takes to win. I've marked out for it just like you said. The fans have enjoyed it. Dino Bambino has become a serious force in ACW, as Sam Hain will tell you, as MPW will tell you, as anyone who watches and enjoys wrestling across the United States will tell you, as this one's on, Dino Bambino sinking the right hand into the Predator, Jason Green.
And you know what? If you allow me to draw the comparison here, he reminds me a little bit of Foley, Mick Foley, in a sense that the memorable matches that he's been involved with, he doesn't win them all the time. He has been just right there at the forefront of all the greatness that has become ACW, and you see a great move by Dino Bambino.
Heel trip into an ankle lock. The Predator down on the canvas, face first. I'll tell you what, Jason Green at first was stifling any attempt at offense from Dino Bambino. But right now, Dino breaking through those defenses.
If Dino is the guts of ACW, Kamikaze Ken is the heart and soul. I really believe in Jason the Predator Green. You are seeing the future of ACW.
You are seeing a major player in the making in All-Star Championship Wrestling and professional wrestling in general. Jason Green showing some good savvy there. Leaped out of the way, gets clotheslined. Dino Bambino sent sailing onto the floor and into the guardrail here at the Two Rivers Community Center. And there's the superstar getting his shots in. Typical modus operandi from the superstar. Once Jason Green does the damage, in comes Mike Mercury to pick up the scraps.
And superstar made him wear that railing like a hat. He was just pounding the body of Dino Bambino into those rails.
Jason Green is just a chisel. Incredibly physically gifted. Takes him over there.
You know, he's a natural. I mean, honest to God, whether you like him or not, you watch him, he is a natural in the ring. It's a guy with his experience should not know to go from A to B to C to D to E to F. He just moves the match along beautifully. He is an up-and-rising talent here, and he's up against one of the veterans, if you can say it about a young guy. But as long as there's been ACW, there has been Dino Bambino.
And I'll tell you what, Doug, you can't just attribute that rapid development to Mike Mercury. Yeah, Mercury gets his influence in. He lets his voice be heard, but some wrestlers are just natural. We've got two of them inside the ring right now. The veteran Dino Bambino, the veteran flyer Dino Bambino, and the chisel, the solid Jason Green. Master submission wrestling. Look at Dino Bambino!
There's
Dino,
the lifeline.
Dino finally got sick of Mike Mercury's constant attempts at interference. He comes flying over the ropes for that somersault tope. But Jason Green takes full advantage, sends Dino Bambino once again into that steel.
Face first.
Dino can't be enjoying that too much.
And then he puts the bad mouth on him.
He's not intimidated, not in the least. Neither of these men are ever intimidated.
And Green throws Dino in, who is holding his head. He has been smacked into that railing more than once so far.
Dino has been waylaid from those constant shots to the head from the guardrail. He rolls him up, count of two. Dino knows he's got to get out of this situation pretty quickly. He's not feeling too good right now. His marbles have got to be, to say the least, rearranged. But the Predator, Jason Green, is not about to let up on him. Sets him up. Holds him up vertical. Look at that hang time. Vertical suplex.
You know, I don't mind stirring up some trouble for superstar Mike Mercury, but, you know, Mercury's always dropping and discarding partners here. How long before the Predator, Jason Green, outgrows superstar?
Mercury stirs up enough trouble on his own, so you don't really have to help him, Doug. But I think Mercury smartened up once he saw just how much potential Jason Green had to make an impact on All-Star Championship Wrestling, and more importantly, carry the superstar back up to the top with him. Jason's just getting vicious right now. The Predator is just getting vicious. We've seen rookie mistakes from the kid. We saw it in a tag team match not too long ago.
There's that strength. Look at the strength.
Powers him up. That's 220 pounds of live weight. Oh, garrotes him.
He hangs him across the top.
Maximum impact from that maneuver. Dino Bambino struggling to regain his composure here. Jamie Kennedy trying to wave off Jason Green, but he's fully acclimated, and he knows what he can do right now.
And keep in mind, Dino called this match. He wanted this match.
Be careful what you wish for, as the cliche goes, doesn't it?
He's got a long ways to go. Can he get all the way across?
Look at him go. Perching himself across that middle rope. One for the headbutt. Nobody home on that one. Took a little too long setting that up. And this right now is Dino time. Right now, Dino's got to fire up. Two Rivers, no doubt, will be behind Dino Bambino. There they go.
Dino Bambino, the Hardcore Luchador, trying to get back to his feet.
He's fighting up. Jason Green already back on his feet. Jason Green stalks. Dino Bambino goes in for the lariat. Wow! Bicycle kick from Dino Bambino. Plants him, spinning leg lariat. There's that offense we're accustomed to seeing from Dino.
Dino Bambino doesn't fly as much as maybe he used to, but he still has it in him to take it in high impact. Well, he's got Jason Green in the corner. What's
sets
he going?
Oh!
Superstar shoves Kennedy in the rhythm.
The Weasel got sandwiched in between two big, meaty, intense wrestlers. And right now, anything's going to go because Jamie Kennedy is down.
That is the Superstar who shoved Jamie Kennedy between Dino Bambino and the Predator.
Bino picks up Jason Green, setting him up here. We know what's coming, Doug. Bino bomb!
But there's nobody to count.
The Superstar poised on the outside, though. I don't know what Superstar's trying to do there.
Oh, he's counting two. There's no one to finish the count.
Dino was waiting for that count right there. Dino getting impatient. Keep your eye on the Superstar. Jason Green struggling back to his feet. He took a hell of a Bino bomb, and he's getting back up. Dino laying those boots in.
Dino Bambino.
Wait a minute, going for the acai. He got it, line salt. Dino wants it one more time. Superstar just fired that chair in his face.
Nice job, Superstar.
Superstar moving furniture.
Getting himself involved again.
And there he comes. Jamie Kennedy still way out of it. Mike Mercury, he hasn't endeared himself to anybody tonight. Look out! Look at Dino. What athleticism. Gets out of that position. Leg sweeps Mike Mercury.
Dino now.
Dino wants to take out his frustrations on his old foe.
But look at
Dino
the Predator.
Dino wants the Superstar. He's not going to get it. He's going to get the shit in the Maki.
Known to me as the Cobra Clutch. I don't know Japanese.
What the Japanese call this is lights out. Dino's trying to fight his way out. Takes Jason Green to the corner. It's not enough. He's cutting the air off. He's cutting the blood off. Jamie Kennedy's made his way back into the ring. Dino fights away.
Pinning attempt. There's a pinning attempt.
Dino got the leverage. Count of two. Did he kick out?
It's Dino.
No, that's all. That's all. Dino got it. Dino Bambino.
The Hardcore Luchador.
Yes.
Dino Bambino.
That was impressive.
But he never gave up the... He never gave up the Cobra Clutch, and Dino's out.
He still got it locked in. Dino Bambino's in a world of hurt, and they've got to release this maneuver. There's Loker. Big Daddy Loker, he's not done with Green. He's not done with the Superstar yet. He saves his partner.
Yeah, but look, the Predator is not intimidated at all. He stands there. Now Superstar says, come on, let's go.
The Predator was ready to have a little more fight in him, but the Superstar cagily pulls Jason Green away. He needs that man for another day, for several more days
in
All-Star Championship Wrestling.
I think this is your classic case, Matt. Dino wins the battle, but who's on his back in the middle of the ring? Dino is. Dino wins the battle, but did Jason win the war?
Jason Green and Mike Mercury asserted themselves tonight. However, Dino and Mike Mercury are going to hook it up one more time. The rivalry gets redone in All-Star Championship Wrestling.
This next match is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute television time limit. Your referee, Jamie the Weasel Kennedy. Coming out first, accompanied by the Predator, Jason Green, from Green Bay, Wisconsin, weighing at 226 pounds, Superstar Mike Mercury.
We are all the way live, All-Star Championship Wrestling on UPN 32, the Midwest ass-kicking machine in full effect at the watering hole. Matt Byron and Angel Armani.
You got it, brother.
And the revival of one of the most classic feuds in Midwest wrestling history. The feud that put ACW on the map and kept us there. One-on-one for the first time in, I believe, 18 months.
Quiet.
Mercury versus Bambino. Needless to say,
I said a moment of silence.
Needless to say, your moment's not being felt by the water.
You don't listen to anybody, do you?
And his opponent.
Not even my boss.
From New Jersey, the Hardcore Luchador.
Angel, it was right here, September 1999, the match, the feud that put ACW on the map. Dino Bambino versus Mike Mercury, best two out of three tables. Dino Bambino came off the score stand with that incredible rolling senton on the Mike Mercury and established himself as a major player in the Midwest wrestling scene.
Well,
now, 18 months later, these two men, their hair is shorter, but the desire is still there. They're going to lock it up again.
I would like to say I have to give my hats off where credit is due, but I don't have a hat on my head, so I don't have to.
Waka, waka, waka. Does Henny Youngman's estate know you stole his material?
I borrow.
Okay. I'll tell you what, though, there is one new aspect to this old rivalry. That's the Predator, Jason Green, on the outside. We're underway. Jamie Kennedy calling for the bell. And the superstar taking full advantage. The roles are reversed here. There's a big scissors kick. Jason Green grabs two handfuls of Dino on the outside, and Mercury going to work those forearms. Angel, these two bring the best out in one another.
No kidding.
Big
drop kick. Is he got height on that?
Dino Bambino
can hang mistletoe.
Is pure guts, pure adrenaline, and one of the damnedest high flyers I've ever seen. And he's throwing some impressive right hands into the side of the face.
Try not to swear when you say it.
I'll try very hard.
Big clothesline. Like lightning quick.
Everything Dino does is lightning quick.
Yeah, right.
Time for chops. Notice how they turn that up when I say it. Because it is time for chops, and Mike Mercury is feeling it right now. Dino shoots him in for the reversal. Jason Green's on the apron. Come on, Jamie, look for Jason. Oh!
Wow.
And Dino got straddled thanks to Jason Green timing.
He had to pop a knee on there or something.
He might have popped a knee. He might have torn a groin. He might have pulled a thigh muscle. So dangerous up on that corner. Those turnbuckles.
He's going to do something here, and it ain't going to be pretty.
The superstar is going to work.
Maybe it will be pretty.
Not much that Mike Mercury's done.
Look at that referee.
Jamie Kennedy trying to count him out. Oh, Mercury took too long, setting up for what looked to be a superplex. And he got deposited onto the canvas. Keep your eye on Dino Bambino, the hardcore luchador. Dino's up top. No, he got Jason Green rolling senton. What an amazing senton tope.
Did you see that?
That was incredible. The superstar celebrating on the outside, but I guarantee
Mike
you,
still doesn't know where even he is.
I'll guarantee you Jason Green's not celebrating. I don't think Bambino's celebrating either.
I think it took out of both of them. This is Mercury's break right here.
Mercury taking full advantage of the situation. You know, Bambino stunned from that incredible high-impact aerial offensive maneuver.
That was insane. Does he hate these men that bad?
And he got...
Oh!
He caught himself on that post. I thought he was going to that guardrail. He tried to catch himself on that post. He paid for it.
You see that guy in the front row tell Mike Mercury he's number one?
A lot of people tell Mike Mercury he's number one.
I seen it.
Look out for Mercury. Right, sends him in again. Ow!
Oh, my goodness.
God,
he's hurt.
He's just punishing the hell out of Bambino
right
into
here,
the head and
right
sternum.
Right here, the referee should call the match. Start over maybe on the 15th, whatever.
Jamie Kennedy giving these guys all sorts of leeway. And look at this. Jason Green also getting involved.
Are they going to run away into that ring post?
Battering ring. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Did you see Dino Bambino land? Did you see Dino Bambino land on the back of his neck?
Oh, wait a minute here.
I've never seen anything. I've never, ever seen anything like that. I've never seen Dino Bambino take impact like that.
I mean... Armani's never lost words. Never. I don't believe this.
He's got all the guts and all the heart.
And look at him.
He's fearless. But I'll tell you what, you take impact like that on
your
spinal column.
He's fearless. He's done.
Lays him down, that big chop across the sternum. God.
Now this could be a mistake, my Merc. I think he just went for a cover and forget the whole thing.
Yeah, Bambino's out.
He's out, he's
done.
He
is flat out. He is flat out unconscious. There's a backbreaker, two-handed press. Oh! Maybe he's not out.
That's instinct. You ever cut a bluegill in half on the ice and it still snaps? That's all this is right now. He didn't kick out of that.
Either that or it's amazing recruitment powers by Dino Bambino. If Mercury Mercury apparently trying to be humane about this.
Trying to break his back.
Well, that's not humane at all, especially when Jason Green helped you. Trying to get that, see that Boston Crab in. Dino Bambino trying to power out of it, but he doesn't have the strength.
You know, I thought I heard him submit. If you keep your mouth shut, I could hear it. The ref couldn't even hear it. I heard him submit.
Then why isn't the ref calling for the bell?
Because you're talking so loud he couldn't hear it.
Oh, it's my fault.
Well, isn't everything?
It seems like it.
Nice. Count him number one again.
The superstar continuing to work Dino Bambino slowly, very slowly, struggling to his feet.
I don't know how.
Oh my God, he's coming back. He's throwing those shots into the midsection.
How. I have no idea.
Dino Bambino is an amazing athlete. He's syncing him up for the Bino Bomb. Jason Green pulls him down. Jason Green went for the clothesline. He got Jamie Kennedy.
Stupid referee again.
That stupid referee, as you call him,
I love
is
him.
Out. And Bambino was trying to work on Jason Green. He couldn't send him down. But look out for Mercury. Take them backwards.
Wow.
That piggyback suplex.
I don't think he threw him back. I think them punches almost knocked him out.
Jamie Kennedy has been waylaid, and the Predator going, look at the agility on Jason Green.
I love it.
Walking those ropes a la the Spoiler.
So what about this 1999 again? Repeat what's happening. Because
wow.
I'm not talking about the past that made Dino Bambino a big thing in his promotion. Let's talk about right now. There's your big thing right there laying on the ground. Look at it. Why talk about 99? Let's talk about right now. Look at him.
He may
Look
not have much of a present or a future.
Why don't you talk about the past now? Because the people are seeing the
Double
future.
Clothesline. Nobody home. Bambino.
They caught him.
He got caught by both men.
Yeah.
There's two men doing damage inside the ring. Mike Mercury finally found his weapon to use against Dino Bambino.
Look at this, it's over. Look at this beautiful move. Go ahead, ref.
Rolls him up, cradling both legs. Jamie Kennedy slow on the draw. Count of two. No!
Unbelievable.
I'm amazed at his powers, to recoup their powers.
But everything Dino Bambino has done, these guys have scouted it and stopped it. Everything.
They've wrestled each other for years on end.
He doesn't have much left. I don't see any kids
but he's up.
Anywhere.
He's up. Rolls him up. Rolling reverse cradle. Got the leverage. Only a count of one. Bambino's back up. Flying cradle right there. Count of one. Only a count of two. He's still staggering around inside the ring.
Kick him.
Trying
kick
to get his facilities. All There's
right.
the Enziguri.
There you go. See, I don't know ESP myself. It was about three doors away.
Next to ODB and
referee looks okay now. Look at him.
Yeah, Jamie Kennedy's back on his feet.
For a change? How long has it been? About a month?
He's a brave man, that Jamie Kennedy. So is Dino Bambino. I don't think
Who?
There's anyone braver than Dino Bambino. He is reaching deep down inside after that traumatic blow on the outside and fighting Mike Mercury, fighting his longtime rival toe for toe inside the ring here at the watering hole, doing ACW proud, going in with those right hands. Shoots Merc in, caught him with that drop kick, not as well as he wanted to.
He just touched him, but he got enough to get him down.
It was enough to stagger him just enough. Mercury's waiting in the corner there.
But remember right here, you're not beating one person, you're beating two. What do you call that? Butt splash?
Good enough for me.
That sounds good to me.
Dino Bambino trying to do some damage here. Jason Green's up on top. Look out for Jason Green.
You got to have eyes behind your head.
For the Predator. Comes up. Oh!
No!
He splashed Mercury. Bino
was
nowhere to
be
found. Bino trying to get Jason Green out of the wing. Powers him out of that clothesline. Bambino, we have seen one hell of a match,
get up, one hell of an effort. Get up.
And we're about to see the move that Dino Bambino made famous all across the Midwest.
Get up.
Shooting star!
Oh.
Twisting shooting star. Count of one, count of two, that's all. One amazing effort from one amazing athlete. Dino Bambino continues to write his legend across ACW and the entire wrestling industry. You're at a loss for words, are you?
I am. These last two matches, I'm a loss for words. I'm a loss. I'm getting a little Italian in here.
Jason Green disposing of Mike Mercury as Dino Bambino. You know he's going to be hurting for days, weeks on end. His chiropractor is about to become very rich, but that's a small price to pay for the heart.
But
the
I don't,
guts, the desire of Dino Bambino.
I agree 100%. I don't think Dino Bambino even knows where he's at right now. That move where he took his back into that ring post, I mean,
He fell from a height of what had to be 8-9 feet onto the back of his neck. It folded him up. And Dino Bam, God, that kid's got to be hurting. But you got to respect the guts, the desire of Dino Bambino.
He's insane.
He's hardcore.
For the remainder of this evening, Jamie the Weasel Kennedy. Coming out first, accompanied by Tommy Roxx from Tampa, Florida, weighing at 225 pounds, Gazette-swimming Kevin Krueger.
The multi-tool athlete, the physical specimen of All-Star Championship Wrestling, makes its way into the gravel pit on Road to the Gold Weekend on ACW Home Video. Byron and the Web Monster calling this one for you as the tiny master of today, as Michiki might say, Tommy Roxx, leads in his impressive athlete, a man who had one of the most incredible title runs in All-Star Championship Wrestling history. God Gift the Women, Kevin Krueger, looking to get back on the winning track tonight.
God's gift to farm animals, God's gift to inflatable women, maybe? I don't know about God's gift to women. And if he is that, then what's he doing hanging around the president of the Glee Club?
Tommy Roxx seems like God's gift to the Backstreet Boys, quite frankly. Tommy Roxx looks like a maitre d' at Plato's Retreat.
And his opponent, weighing in it.
Kevin Krueger, not allowing his opponent to be in.
My manager, Mr. Tommy Roxx, has something to say.
Go on, Tommy, get heat, I dare you. Twist your arm.
He's not gonna sing us the song, is he?
No, that's not his gimmick. You might want to try getting a little bit lower pants. Looking at those socks. I don't know. It's not really working with the ensemble, quite frankly.
Well, when you're wearing a glitter,
kill Wisconsin!
Calm down, young man. Speak into the mic. Use your inside
voice.
There's
only two reasons any of you people are here tonight in Kill Wisconsin.
Use your words, Tommy.
One is to see Mr. Sex Appeal himself, God's gift to women, Kevin Krueger. Look at that right there. Look at this physique.
If he's Mr. Sex Appeal, who's Mrs. Sex Appeal? Is she here tonight? Maybe it's Cleo.
I don't even think Cleo would touch Krueger with a 10-foot pole.
A lot of women like to steer clear of God's gift to women, Kevin Krueger, especially the women at Studio 8
in
Manitowoc.
You know my opponent tonight, shut up all you pukes.
Pukes?
My opponent tonight.
That's after the show.
Mr. Dino Bambino. Shut up.
Krueger set to renew his rivalry against one hell of an impressive athlete, Dino Bambino, tonight.
One thing I'll say, Dino Bambino has never beaten God's gift to women.
That's
Kevin
disputable.
Kruger.
That's disputable, Mr. Krueger. We
Bambino,
saw it happen in Two Rivers.
You're gonna lose tonight. Get your ass out here so I can kick your ass.
Gratuitous use of the word ass by Kevin Krueger. You know he's fired up.
205 pounds. From Holmes Park, New Jersey, hardcore Dino Bambino.
The most absolutely fearless man to ever step foot in an ACW ring, I dare say any wrestling ring, anywhere in the Midwest, anywhere across the country. This kid is pure guts, pure adrenaline, pure and absolute aerial fearlessness. Dino Bambino. He's had so many opportunities at the ACW title. We've seen him get cheated out of it once against Kevin Krueger and Tommy Roxx, thanks to the inability to keep track of time of Jimmy Kennedy. We're waiting on Dino Bambino right now. Dino's not changing his shoes, is he? TJ, what do you think he is?
Not this close to the match, I hope. He's in the ring.
He's in the ring. Where'd he come from? Dino Bambino's in the ring. What, he come out of the bar? Tommy Roxx has been disposed of. Krueger, hello. We're playing kissy face with Will. Yeah. Getting those traps in shape. Dino Bambino, the gentleman. Looking good, aren't you, Kevin? Kevin, this is going to suck for you as soon as you turn around. Hello! Dino Bambino shoves Krueger down to the canvas. We're already off and running on this one.
It's on. It's
not,
on.
Not by conventional means, but this match is underway. We're going to see this one more time. Two athletes, I think, very diverse, yet match up very well in the Hardcore Luchador. Dino Bambino, there's that seated dropkick. And God's get to him and Kevin Krueger. Dino's such a master of aerial offense. Krueger, there isn't anything I don't think he can do. Nonetheless, Dino Bambino is top. Dino Bambino is willing to go with you no matter how you want to bring it. No matter how you want to play it, Bambino's ready to go. Any kind of match, baby. And Kevin Krueger better find someplace quiet to be and collect himself, quite frankly, that monster.
Unconventional is the word for Dino Bambino. You know, it may not have been officially marked down in the record books, but there's no denying that Dino absolutely found.
Somersault, senton halo, nicely done by Dino Bambino. Aerial offense is the key, is the rule of the day when you're dealing with Dino Bambino. He can come from any side, any direction, any position, TJ.
Dino definitely flattened Krueger in two rivers that night, even though it didn't go down as a win, and he just flattened him again outside the ring, and he's keeping on him.
Dino Bambino made a statement to God, keep the women that night. Oh my God, taking out a whole section of guardrail.
And a whole section of fans, too.
Dino Bambino, maximum impact on that Irish whip. Flattening, waylaying Kevin Krueger. Keep your eye on him, though. Keep your eye on Bambino.
Oh, this can't end well.
Tommy Roxx wants something there. Oh, Tommy Roxx got just enough in, and Jamie Kenny was distracted. Bambino comes crashing to the canvas, and Krueger better take advantage right now.
Looks like he's doing just that, Darren.
On the outside, keeping it simple. Keeping Dino Bambino on the defensive. Keeping him those forearms, sitting in those boots.
Give him the ring!
I'll tell you what, Krueger, he's seen with that legendary Robert Rams, Kamikaze Ken Anderson, the small Adino's back, crashes into that post thanks to God's Gift to Women.
You know Krueger's not thinking about Kamikaze Ken. He's not thinking about any titles tonight.
He doesn't have a title to think of. He wants to get back in that ACW title picture. He wants to establish himself once again. And once again, Dino Bambino.
And once again, Weasel's being distracted by Tommy Roxx.
Jamie the Weasel Kennedy, we're down to one referee tonight. Or maybe you could make a case, say a half a referee. I'll tell you what, though, Dino Bambino, he's not holding anything back. And 24 hours from now, he's got one last dance. With the man who quite worked. Two men who made each other famous in ACW and all across the Midwest. Scrap Iron Adam Pearce returns one final time to All-Star Championship Wrestling.
The cage match at Beat the Heat last year voted match of the year.
By Tim Larson's Upper Midwest Wrestling newsletter.
That's right, so who knows what they're going to pull out of their hat tomorrow night.
One more time, gentlemen, it was never fully solved. There's always something left to prove, and quite frankly, for over a year and a half, it's been simmering inside these two. Dino Bambino hung up on that top rope. Krueger's got a challenge tomorrow night against former TV champion Eric Hammer as he tries to make his way back up the championship contention ladder. Wow. Bambino, huge right hand into the midsection. I'll tell you what, those are chiseled abs. A Bambino can throw a punch with the best of them. Kevin Krueger collapses on top of Bambino, though, only a count of two.
Lost his balance, and to Krueger's credit, he manages to capitalize on any mistake that he can make. Even though Bambino doesn't make a whole lot of them, but he is a risk taker.
He's a risk taker, and when he does make that big mistake, when it comes to TJ, it's usually something that's pretty incapacitating. But I'll tell you what, we've seen Bambino take so much punishment. We've seen him take the flaming table from Hayne. We've seen him take fireballs from Hayne. We've seen those 2 out of 3 tables matches with Mike Mercury, with Sam Hayne, Adam Pearce, and him with that legendary work in ACW all across the Midwest. I'll tell you what though, tomorrow night, Bambino appears they will put it on the line. It's a matter of pride inside that ring. One last chance inside the watering hole. There's that bicycle kick from Dino Bambino.
He's going up.
Bambino, I'll tell you what, he's not gun shy. Not one getting twice shy either. I'm sure even the Lynch will appreciate that. He's on top. Oh! He wanted to shoot and start. What the hell happened there?
I didn't see it.
What the hell happened there?
The Krueger's right back up on him.
I don't know if Bambino threw his back out or what the hell happened. He's been punished. He's been taking those stomps. He's been taking those hard shots on the outside. That had to be what happened, TJ. His back just completely went south on him.
I don't know, because there's Tommy Roxx distracting the Weasel again. I think Weasel has ADD.
I think a little Ritalin might be in the Weasel's future. Planted by Kevin Krueger. Dino Bambino back in that cannon. He was just throwing punches, swinging wildly on instinct. This kid is a fighter all the way around.
Come on, baby.
Dino looking the worst for wear. He was in control, but I didn't see what happened there. I don't know why he's on the receiving end now. Oh, Krueger right in the cannon.
I'll tell you what, though, for all of Bambino's ability, for all of his presence, for all of just his raw talent, you're in there with an 11-year veteran of the squared circle and God's gift to him, Kevin Krueger. He's not going to wear out on you. He's not going to blow up on you. He's not going to get tired. And he's always thinking. He's a ring general.
No matter what you think of him, God's gift to women or otherwise, you can't discount Kevin Krueger when it comes to his ability in the ring.
Doing some damage right now. He's got that. Looks like he set him up for that Oriental crossbow hole, TJ.
And if Dino threw out his back, this is not helping.
This is not exactly the chiropractic visit he needs right about now.
No.
Kevin Krueger is just sinking that right foot, that right shin into the small of the back of Dino Bambino. Road to the Gold Weekend. We are glad to come at you on ACW Home Video and the gravel pit and keel reversal. Sunset flip from Dino, count of two.
How does Dino do it?
His resiliency is amazing. We saw it in the watering hole not too long ago, just a few weeks ago. Jason Green and Mike Mercury dropped this kid smooth on his head from 8 feet in the air. We thought he was dead, quite frankly. We thought he was seriously injured. We thought he was paralyzed. And this kid just got back up and kept fighting. And Kevin Krueger is finding out right now, Dino Bambino does not stop fighting, does not stop competing. And we're finally starting to see a little bit of frustration on the face of God's Gift to Women.
He's going up top.
Puts it on top rope. Like you said, Kevin Krueger, a multi-tool athlete. He is comfortable up on that top rope. He is comfortable in the air.
I don't think he's Jimmy Snuka, apparently, but.
Shaka Bra, nothing doing on the Superfly Splash.
Both men down now. Who's got the advantage?
Face down on the canvas. The Weasel finally doing his job, laying in that count.
Come on, baby.
They both got a contact to get up. It's kind of sick right now.
Come on, Kevin, baby.
They're both struggling to their knees, both struggling to their feet.
They're hurting. Dino makes it to his feet, though, and so does Krueger.
Dino Bambino's legs not looking good right now. A little bit wobbly, but he's still got enough to throw his right hand. Krueger trying to get some fist to cuckmanship to himself, but Bambino just too quick with those big right hands. Dino can always rely on that offense. He's got some most impressive punches in wrestling. There's once again a bicycle tick. Bicycle kick, too. Bambino's got the gravel pit fired up.
Krueger's in prime position for a move off the top. Oh, but he makes it to his feet.
He struggles to his feet. Setting off. Might be a Michinoku driver right down. Just a scoop and a slam. Quite enough at this juncture of the match. Lion Salt, nicely done.
Beautiful.
Got a two.
Tommy Roxx looking a little frustrated himself out there in, at ringside.
Tommy Roxx is flustered outside the ring. There's a spinning heel kick from Bambino. Finally, Tommy Roxx makes his way to the top, to the ring apron. Bambino has no love for this young man.
He wasn't frustrated before, he is now.
Almost a collision there from Krueger and Tommy Roxx. Bambino makes his way outside the ring, disposes of Tommy Roxx. Oh! Hard forearm to the back. He forgot all about Kevin Krueger.
That was a mistake. You do not turn your back on this guy.
A big mistake. Krueger setting him up. We might be looking at a lady killer right here, TJ. No, he blocked it. Bambino blocked it. Fell to his knees. Picks it right back up. Swing neck breaker. No, he's setting him up. We've seen this before, Web Monster. Almost devastating offensive maneuvers into the upper Midwest. The Beano Bomb!
Unbelievable.
Beano Bomb plants God's gift to women.
That's it.
It's a count of three. Tommy Roxx just a second too late. I'll tell you what, no title on the line, but that's gotta feel good. The Dino Bambino finally getting an undisputed three count against God's gift to women, Kevin Krueger. Hours from now, as impressive as this was, it all means nothing. Bambino, Adam Pearce, one last dance, one final go-around, one final competition for the fans, for their pride. Inside the watering hole in Green Bay, Road to the Gold weekend continues. And tonight we've got more great action coming in Kiel. Kevin Krueger lives to fight another day. As a matter of fact, he's got to fight in another day. He's got to fight Eric Hammer. ACW Commissioner Mickey Doyle coming to the ring. Road to the Gold, part one in Kiel. Saw Scrap Iron Adam Pearce win the TV title. Here at the watering hole, Scrap Iron Adam Pearce, no show. Mickey Doyle's going to talk about it.
We got caught in a snowstorm, who knows. Anyway, what we got to do is we're going to have to strip him of the title. Now, Dino Bambino, I know you're back, but I wish you'd come on down here for a minute. Come on, Dino. Dino Bambino, come on out here. Let's talk about this TV title.
Dino Bambino supposed to go up against Scrap Iron Adam Pearce. Pearce no showing tonight. Who the hell knows where Scrap Iron is?
Come
go
on,
to
Dino,
California.
Come
you come
here.
Back too cool for the room, I guess. So they're calling out Dino Bambino. Can't believe they just give Dino the title. So we'll see how this all works out. Here comes Dino Bambino, who's going to challenge for the title tonight. So right now, a little bit of confusion reigning here at Road to the Gold. Last night, Matt Byron was down. Last night, Matt Byron was down at Kiel at Road to the Gold. I was not there. I'm battling this cold. I'm losing my voice, as you can tell. All of a sudden, Byron is in here. Nobody knows where Byron is. He's there last night. I wish I could fill you in on what's going on right now, but I'm kind of in the dark as well. Kind of count on Mickey Doyle filling the gaps for me. It's like I've been out all night, woke up, have no idea what the hell's going on in ACW.
Everything I can do is award you, call you the TV champion right now.
Is this possible?
Is the team of that being right now?
We're joined now by two-time champ Adrian Lynch. Coming in here.
I didn't come to Green Bay to be handed a title. I came to Green Bay to fight.
Adrian, what do you make of this thing with Scrap Iron no showing tonight, losing the, being stripped of the belt?
Well, you need an opponent for that.
I'll get into that in a minute, Dakar Kaufman. First, I want to see what Doyle has to say.
Oh, I know this music.
It sounds vaguely familiar.
You know it ain't Reggie White.
There, for sure.
There it is.
There's my boy.
Shifty's coming out. Yeah, he's your pal, isn't he?
Well, yeah. You know, people here at ACW would like to think better of that. How can you legally ban someone from being friends? Because that's what it comes down to, Kaufman.
What do you mean? You guys lost that match. This past fall, you're banned from ACW. You come in and use those ridiculous luchador masks. And then you guys get back in it. I don't know how it works.
You know, there's really no need to rehash the past, Coffee. Why don't we get into the situation here? What was this match advertised as being?
Scrap Iron Adam Pearce versus Dino Bambino. Pearce, no show.
You know, I was going to say, I look at this ring and I don't see Scrap Iron Adam Pearce. Could it be that he's a coward?
Could it be
he's afraid to show up?
You tell me.
I mean, it was last night in the Keel. He managed to win the belt, but he doesn't show up to defend it. Now, in my book, that means he's a coward.
Seems to me we're agreeing on
this. Yeah, for once we're in agreement, Kaufman.
We got it. Two things we agree on. Alexis, Scrap Iron. By the way, I need to ask you since I have you here.
Yes, sir. Oh, I'm sorry. Wait, did I just call you sir?
It's all right. Was that a trade up or down for Stefano?
My personal life is none of your business, Kaufman.
Well, I'm just curious.
Just because the business happens to lapse into the, or creep over into the personal life with Alexis, doesn't mean the same thing's going on with Stefano. I'm kind of offended that you would suggest that.
Just ask it. Sometimes I live my life vicariously through you.
Well, and I appreciate that, but let's concentrate on the match here.
TV title is on the line. Shifty, Dino Bambino.
Collar and elbow tie-up. You don't see much of that anymore.
It might be the last move we see in this for a while. Both guys like to fly high. Both guys like to fly up top.
Well, look at Shifty just working it. He's the man. Really, these people in Green Bay don't appreciate greatness.
You'll have to excuse me a little bit. I have no idea. We're talking about no-showing. Nobody knows where the hell Byron is. I got a call this morning to come here and do the thing. I'm sick as a dog. Byron was in Keel last night. Nobody knows where he is. We've been here all night long. No sign of Byron. I don't know what the hell he's up to either. Maybe he's hanging out with Scrap Iron.
I doubt that Byron has more class than that. That's probably the first time you hear me compliment Byron.
Yeah, he's real pro here. He's leaving me out here working with Angel Armani. I never met the guy before. Oh, what a move! Now that is the high flying move.
Shifty playing possum caught him.
That's a great move by Shifty. Two guys who can fly high. We're going to see these guys elevating all night long in this TV title match. Well, there's a spinning body, whatever. Got a word for it? Help me out.
Who's the man? Shifty is. You know, something tells me you wouldn't see Scrap Iron Adam Pearce do that.
Something tells me I wouldn't see him doing it either. Something tells me grab a chair, beat the hell out of somebody, then not show up.
Don't forget to punch out someone.
That's true.
You know, I noticed there was a guy in a wheelchair here at the building tonight. Had Scrap Iron been here, I was kind of curious if he'd just tip over the wheelchair.
Shifty, gaining momentum against Dino Bambino. Has him tied up, bottom rope, choking him out. Breaks for just a second, now goes back on the choke. Has a count of five to do so.
Craig Smith being a little strict here.
Tell you what, whether you like Shifty or not, or the old MPW gang, Shifty's a bright talent, probably without question. No offense, because I still think you're ACW deep down.
Wait, did you say you were sick?
A little bit.
Move a little over here. I don't want to catch it. No offense.
Shifty has always been the shining light in MPW. He's always had the skills, always had the talent, and he's the guy who had the gold for a while. Going for it again against Dino Bambino.
Beautiful drop kick by Shifty.
So, road to the goal. You had your shot against Kamikaze Ken. What happened?
two-time former champ, six-year veteran.
What the hell you mean what happened? You beat me. Weren't you watching?
Yeah, I thought maybe there was a reason why. Stefano had a bunch of reasons.
But I lived another day to fight. Trust me, you'll be hearing a lot of big things in the future out of me. That's the thing about me is I always have something cooking.
I don't doubt that one bit. Bambino battles to his feet, side headlock, couple of elbows to the guts. Takes a knee to his own guts. Shifty gains momentum back in this title match.
Can't you just hear the people are chanting, Shifty, Shifty, Shifty. I can
what is it with you and Armani? You don't hear what they're actually saying.
Don't compare me to Armani.
You guys just make stuff up out here.
Don't compare me to Armani.
I won't.
I'm a better dresser. What was that look for?
Cowboy boots and Zumbas.
You'll never see me wear
cowboy. But it works for you.
Climb up, Coffin.
Shifty's
boots off my Shifty.
Oh. No one's home. That's the momentum switch Dino Bambino needs.
This is a hell of a match so far. It's curious. It's interesting to speculate on what would happen if Scrap Iron Hat showed up. Were Scrap Iron to hit Dino Bambino? I mean, there's a big difference between Dino Bambino and a retarded kid. I mean, you know, Bino would actually hit back.
He would fight back. Yeah. Dino Bambino, Kamikaze Kid is the heart and soul. Dino Bambino's the guts. Here's the Hardcore Luchador. He's battling to his feet now. Shifty gets to his feet as well. They're both up. Big right hand. Roxx Shifty three times. Back up against the ropes. Whips him on the far side.
Big boot.
Right to the kisser. TV title on the line. Shifty and Dino Bambino reverses.
Set them up.
Oh! One! Oh! Powers him to the mat. Pulls him back up. Oh! Throws a leg drop in for good measure. Good kick out by Shifty. Dino Bambino, a true high-impact player. Has Shifty into the corner. Here he comes! Full speed clothesline. Reverses. Back in, follows up with another clothesline. You've been around ACW since the beginning, so has Dino Bambino. You two guys, the foundation that this federation's built on. Dino going for the TV goal tonight against Shifty. Has him tied up. Flips him over, bulldogs him down, into a DDT, gets the pin! What a move! What do you think about that, Adrian?
Well, I've wrestled both men.
And?
It was a hell of a match. Your new TV champion, Dino Bambino. But you can't discount Shifty.
Shifty had a great match. Whoa, what's going on? Lights are down. Dino Bambino's got the belt.
Whoa. Don't start the party just yet, because superstar Mike Mercury has a little announcement to make. Everybody has been emailing and calling and faxing. I almost had to get a second phone line just to put up with all the crap. Listen up. Everybody wants to know what's up with ACW TV. I'll tell you what's up. ACW was built on one thing. You can ask Kamikaze Ken Anderson. You can ask Eric Hammers. You can ask Mitch Paradise. You can ask Dino Bambino. ACW was built on the fans. Well, here's what I say to the fans. Screw you. ACW was built on this thick back. ACW was built on my hard sweat, on my money, on my time. And I am gonna gut ACW like a fish. And it started. It started with the TV show, but I couldn't do it by myself. I had help. I'm gonna gut ACW from the inside out. And my boy, my long friend, my confidant, Mr. Byron.
Hey, Doug, I know you're missing me.
Yeah.
We pulled the plug on ACW TV, and Mr. Dino Bambino, you're the new ACW TV champion. Well, ACW doesn't have TV. That means we can't have a TV champion. So I want you to do the honorable thing. Put that belt, lay it down in the middle of my ring, and just walk away, and nobody will get hurt. Because when you're dealing with Mr. Matt Byron and superstar Mike Mercury, It's our world. For 3 years, 3 years, all of you human waste strewn across those seats, watching at home, have taken for granted my generosity, my good standing within the broadcast industry, my goodwill, my reputation, and what the hell do I get for it? I get jack. Well, you're about to learn an important lesson in not just wrestling, but in broadcast television, hell, an important life lesson. Byron giveth, and Byron taketh away. You just live in it.
Matt Byron.
And Mike Mercury's in the ring. It's a sneak attack from behind.
Here goes Byron.
Shock. This is Byron. Get out of here, you piece of crap. Get out of here. Get out of here, Byron.
Coffin, he looks a little bit out of shape.
Yeah, you're a tough man. Paul E. Byron. How the hell is this? What's going on out here? Byron's been here all the time. Did you know that?
I know nothing about this. What are you looking at
me for? Come on! There's a guy near the mask. Who's that? Loker. What the hell's Loker? Loker's in there with a mask.
You know, Kaufman.
You're in on the whole thing, aren't
you? No, I'm not.
Oh, come on.
I knew nothing about it.
You're the king of the underhanded trick.
I think these guys finally smartened up.
No. That's a bunch of crap, Lynch. This is right out of your book. You knew the whole time what the hell's going on. You and Byron, Krause, Walker. All right. Why don't you go in and get your clothes out? Byron's as unprofessional as the rest of them.
Oh, who's this tramp?
That's Cleo. You know that.
Like I said, who's the tramp?
That's unbelievable. Oh, Pino! He got cold cocked by hammers! Why do I think you know about this?
I know nothing about this.
Yeah, you're Sergeant Schultz, aren't you? I know nothing, I see nothing.
Who? I was never in the military.
Man, this just stinks.
Some people like to play doctor with me, but not the military.
Are you done?
No, I'm Adrian. Oh, look at this, I'm
Kamikaze Cat just took a shot in the back of the head! Hammers is going nuts now! Who in the world is holding a bird in ACW? What is going on?
Wow!
Cleo's in the ring! She's putting up boots to Kamikaze Cat!
Hammers is overdrawing! Someone's actually paying attention to him!
What is going on in here? You didn't know this either, did you?
No, but I'm kind of excited!
I can tell!
I haven't liked the fact that the tramp is getting in on the act.
What is going on? Loker powers Dino Bambino up. Presses him 2-3 times. Power bomb, Loker bomb. Unbelievable. Hammers the kendo stick again to the head of Kamikaze.
Hit him again. Hey, bet you can't do that again.
Shut up. Byron, superstar.
Oh, they're moving furniture.
Yeah, two men in a truck.
I'm not gonna go stop them.
Of course you wouldn't. I'm surprised you're not out there beating the hell out of somebody.
I'm about to count 9-11. Count 9-11.
This just.
I'm kidding, of course.
Yeah, you're Mr. Funny Man.
I am. I'm a funny guy. I'm gonna get a real kick out of this too.
What the hell are these?
Like, I'm gonna go over there and help Kamikaze Ken Anderson out. What are
you? Yeah, nuts? I just whipped your ass tonight. That's why.
You can't say, you can't use that kind of language on this show.
You beat your ass then.
Oh, I'm sorry, we don't have a TV show.
Yeah, that's true. Man, this is Hammers climbing up top. Kamikaze Ken prone. What's he gonna do?
No!
Flashes him right through the table.
Look at me, Kaufman, I'm crying.
This is unbelievable.
I feel so bad.
Hammers. Loker.
Such a tragedy.
Matt Byron. Superstar. I expect this crap out of superstar Mike Mercury. I don't know what the hell is going on.
That's how we take care of business, huh?
This just stinks.
I think that's you.
No, it's not. It's not Stefano either. It's this whole thing.
Hey, guys, you can take this table. This is unbelievable. So, Loker, what do you do? Borrow your old luchador mask? Or does he have his own?
What are you talking about?
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. This is just crap.
Hammer's just beside himself with joy.
Yeah. This is just... Yeah, yeah, there you go. Everybody hey. Run.
Oh, yeah. Day late and a dollar short.
Yeah, you know what? These guys got to step up a little bit. They just got rid of this crap with MPW. Now you got to deal with it again. Tell you what, I'll put some of the blame on these yo-yos in here from ACW. They got to get on the stick here, figure out what the hell's going on, too.
How do you expect this assortment of clowns in the ring to measure up to these guys over here?
Yeah. You knew the whole time, didn't you?
You knew nothing.
That's why you came out here. You said, hey, I want to sit in on this match. You knew what the hell was going on. You're just here to gloat.
That's right. This is the new ACW.
And I have cold-like symptoms, and I'm mad.
What?
I have cold-like symptoms, and I'm still here to put up with this crap.
Is that contagious?
I'm going to breathe on you. Maybe you'll get sick. Make me feel bad.
Hold on, the old
we
guy's
put
talking.
16 months into making this TV what it is, getting the fan base. You guys aren't just going to come along in one night. I got news for you. January the 18th, the next show at the Watering Hole. First and foremost, D.D. Loker, you're going to get your shot against Dino Bambino. Let's see if you can be a TV champion. I doubt it. Team County Hammers. You're going to get a little action, too, against the Kamikaze.
I think he has
see
been.
If you can be an ACW champ. I don't think so, punk. Byron, Mike Mercury. You guys are a joke. You guys, I got a big surprise for you. We're getting the TV back. The professor. Jason, Jay, we've been busting our asses this whole week going to TV stations, talking to people. We're getting TV back. And it'll be ours again. ACW! ACW!
Put him out of the job! No more TV!
ACW! ACW!
Hey, Lynch, I think we gotta go.
The fans are chanting Lynch. Lynch. Lynch.
I don't think you hold that
short respect.
Greater image.
Untouched.
I'm Doug Kaufman. This is ACW Wrestling.